Ladies and gentlemen, it's wonderful. We are here in a very special place called Cormòns, and Cormòns is just a little village on the northeast part of Italy, not so far from Venice. And we are here for a special program. We want to introduce a very nice and spectacular painter called Mauro Modin. Mauro Modin will take your hand and will walk with you in a very special trip composed by music, jazz, blues, and many, many, many different colors. Mauro Modin understood perfectly that jazz music could be an ideal panacea against shallowness. This is the demonstration, ladies and gentlemen. And if it's very easy to find a good remedy for a cold, more complicated would be to find one for the lack of imagination, the lack of ideas, or lack of feelings, emotion, or something else not easily buying in a common supermarket. So, when you open this special medicine cabinet, don't forget to choose, being very careful, the best cure for the moment. And what about the portrait of Rassan Roland Kirk, the famous multi-instrumentist who was able to play three saxophones at once and who died very young in 1977? On these silk stamps, Mauro Modin's hand was able to make him play on the canvas, all along the measure of the surface, with a very refined technique, a great sensibility, and not least, a very deep knowledge about the personality of the musician. Mauro Modin catch Kirk's souls and evidenced it in a final manner. Don't look it, hear it. Totally different the atmosphere of the Albert Ayler's portrait, the pride of being black, the man who acted in the full awareness of his radical and total new vision, the musician who tried to capture the secret sound of darkness, with his communicating every day with ghost and unmaterial essence. With a few brush strokes, Mauro Modin rebuild a complex personality. In the knoticness of the youth canvas, Mauro Modin is able to hide the mystery of Albert Ayler's life and death from the view of the insensitive onlooker. And then John Coltrane, the great and only, in the last day of his very incredible life. Modin's strong, bold brushwork, intensive, anarchical, spontaneous, reflect the state of mind of the famous saxophonist, while he was searching for the impossible sound of the stars of God. The paint apparently seems a portrait, but if you look it carefully, you will discover a beautiful convergence of signs, colors, and many unexpressible other things. That kind of paint which whom you must leave, discovering it day by day. I recommend to all the friends, look for the paints of Mauro Modin, because Mauro Modin is not only a figurative painter, but he also an abstract too, and he is making some other different things. On this circle stamps, this is a special homage to the audience, for all the people who lives and feels the magician on stage together in front of one or more musicians. And Mauro Modin tried to describe, at his beautiful manner, what's going on in the minds, on the hearts and soul of the people in that moment. He captured something you cannot touch and describe it with a sort of emotional, fantastical new alphabet. Everyone in the crowd feel by his own way, but everyone feels something, and all this positive force go from the people to the musician to return back immediately to the people, lightly modified. A very uncommon manifesto of togetherness. And of course, every single paint represents the feeling, the emotion of one and only man who was there, living at that moment the music and the feeling of stay together. Thanks.